Hey everybody, how's it going? I'm up in northern Michigan today. Client sent me up to go through a 1933 Buick Series 60 sedan. And we got it up on the rack, so that's where we're going to start. Paint's really, really nice on this car. Car was an original build commissioned by Classic Instruments out of Michigan. Done by Great Lakes Motor Works. I think they're up in Boyne City. I can't remember. It's been a long time since I've been there, but they do really exceptional work. And this car appears to be a nice car as well. Done originally in 2002 and kind of freshened in 2013 for the current owner that has it. And I'm looking at it from beneath to begin. Well, starting up front, it's a TCI Mustang 2 rack and pinion setup. Billet adjustable coilovers. I spent a little time studying the front end and how it's set up, because what they did was take an original 33 Buick frame and box it all in. Front to rear, there's no stub on the front of it that I could find, unless they ground it down and really finished it off in a stupendous way, and which may be the case. But the client's concern was how balanced that the front end was, what the wheelbase looked like, and so for starters, all the components and reinforcements are very heavy duty. These lower billet arms were made, and they're adjustable. So the of course there's some adjustment in what the suspension can do, and there's a little room in this lower arm bushing, lower control arm bushing, we'll call it. Same thing applies on this side. Going to be a little cumbersome moving the light around, but you get the idea. So the look and stance of the car looks good on the rack. I haven't studied it on the ground, but let's take a peek at the wheel. So what we did is a rough field measurement earlier. We're going to do it again. I got some assistance on the other end. Okay, I'm pulling.
Center.
Good?
Good.
Good? Okay. Looks like we ended up with about 127.5, and again, this is a rough field measurement. 127.5 or maybe 5/8. Okay.
Center.
Pulling center.
Center.
Center. All right, and it looks like we're at about 127 3/8. Now again, on these rough field measurements, I don't recommend trying this at home. It's just a rough idea while we're out in the field to get a general idea. But if I pull a line off the bottom of this fender edge, which is a little tricky, I'm looking at like a 17.5 to 5/8. I'm going to take a guess. And back here on the right side, we're 17.75, probably, plus or minus there. 17.875. But anyway, that's all, I don't know, plus or minus 3 to 5/8, and it's all adjustable. So the real key will be in the way the car rides down the road. Again, sorry for the weird lighting. Chassis work is real nice though, real heavy duty. Everything's welded up and fabbed up nice. I don't really see anything down here that I don't like. 454 block, I haven't had the hood open yet, and it doesn't look like anybody has freshly wiped this down, which is good. I appreciate that. And that being said, there's not any major oil leaking out of the front main. I don't see anything nasty coming out of the rear main. Transmission pan looks like it's in pretty good shape. Turbo 400. And again, there's a good look at the suspension. These steering knuckles, that's set up really, really cool. It's got adjustable mounts here, and then back here as it goes up and enters through the firewall into the driver's compartment. So I'll be interested to see how the car steers and handles, but doesn't look like there's any kinking or any weird angles that that those knuckles have to achieve. I didn't mention earlier, it's an all steel car, steel running boards, steel body. We did some magnetic adhesion on it earlier, and I'll show some results when we get the car outside. Power brake booster. The reservoir's up there, accessible through the rear floor, I assume. Back ahead of the left rear tire. Stainless cherry bomb style exhaust. Stainless band clamps up there. Rear mount battery. And there's a cable running to the back compartment. It's under the seat. Billet coilovers in the rear. Same four link adjustable. Let me get back there to show this a little better. Little 10 bolt setup with a sway bar. Four wheel disc brake components. Rear end is reported serviced and gone through. I don't see any active leaks or anything abnormal. Backing plates are done up nice. But plenty of adjustment to make the car go straight with the four link setup. I'm sorry about the lighting again. There we go. Okay. Polished fuel tank. Electronic fuel pump. Brake lines and fuel lines all look to be in good serviceable condition. The car could stand some polishing and detailing underneath, but it looks like it was kind of built to be driven, and that's what's happened with it. Exhaust is slung nicely. Certainly is a good looking car from underneath, and has a great look. I'm going to spend a little more time with it outside here. Went through the door lines and body features already, but I think it'll show up better. 100 spoke wheels, those might be Dayton's, I'm not sure. 16's in the front, 17's in the rear. Last thing I wanted to show the onlooker, the potential purchaser, is I polished up a spot on the frame there with my buffing rag, just wiped it down. You can see that'll clean up nicely. It's just some oxidation and road wear, etc. Dust and dirt. Stopping the car halfway down, we'll take a peek at it here on the hoist. And the rear bumper alignment is nice. If I keep the camera level, you can see the bottom edge of the fender lip. I'm doing my best to keep the camera level and field measurement. But car's got a nice, let me see if I can get the camera straight there. Nice square straight look from the back. I'm a little too close in the front to give the onlooker that perspective, but just taking a rough measurement off the edge of the bumper. My handle quit shaking, and I'm just a skosh kind of over 9 inches there, and just a right about at 9 inches. So it's again hard to get perspective. When they put these old cars together, they didn't fit together all that well. And that really wasn't the goal, is to make everything look real perfect, but somebody's done a real nice job assembling this car. In particular, these cars weren't notoriously flat. The panels were fairly wavy, and the door lines didn't always show consistency. But someone has spent an inordinate amount of time blocking those lines and getting those lines, you know, filled, blocked, and flattened. All these older cars, you know, show a level of lines that don't always flush out, like, you know, like obviously today's modern cars, but someone spent plenty of time lining up this car. I've got a little bubble magnet, and if you can listen, you can see the little, we'll call it a tit, moving in the glass. So there's metal down there. It's not just built out of Bondo, but it's been filled and blocked nicely. You can see the reflective quality in the paint is really, really deep. Right now I'm about probably 4 feet away from the car. That won't show up this nicely outside, so it's better to see this inside, but you can see the detail. And the paint, it looks really good down low. A few small, tiny nicks, touch-ups, or flaws. I noticed one over here on the door right there. It's pretty small, pencil lead size. Little hairline scratch right there that probably could be buffed on a little bit. A few small entry, what I call heel scuffs or nicks, along the bottoms of the running board at the entry point. those could be cleaned up and touched up a little bit as well. A couple little stone chips up here in the wheel lip, but it's actually inside the wheel lip, not on the outside focal point. Plenty of meat left on those BF Goodrich Touring TAs. Front tires seem to be wearing appropriately. Don't really see any camber issues, and they don't look like they're brand new. Look like they've had some miles put on them. I know the light's a little dim, but before we get the car, you know, back outside, I'll give you a little bit of the same magnetic adhesion treatment out here. Edges of the fenders are real nice. And let me listen for the click. Oops. Okay. I'll check for a scratch when I'm done. Same thing. So the lines were blocked out real nice. Doors were presenting really super flat and level, and I've got that kind of adhesion running throughout the body. Nothing abnormal, nothing unusual. You got to have some filler to block them straight. And looks good. Got a little chip I noted. We'll look at it outside, but I think it's down here on the very bottom edge going up. All right, we're going to hook her up and do a cold start, get it off the rack. Thank you so much. Oh, that's cool. Coated hooks, as it should have. Nice polished firewall. 69 degrees. Seems 68 degrees. That's about what it is in here. Would you fire that up for me, please? Obvious smoke or anything noted on startup. 454 big block. Can you rev it up for me a little bit, please? Back outside, engine detail is nice, smooth firewall, looks good on both sides. Got an upgraded distributor, chrome coil, dual feed Holley, a vintage or a Sandon compressor actually, but vintage style air conditioning, serpentine pulley setup. Sanderson exhaust, coated manifolds, nice mini torque starter. A pretty good setup all the way through. I just pulled the tranny dipstick. We took pictures of the fluid. It's pink and smells good. And oil looks pretty decent and is within the hash marks. Pop the radiator cap, and it's hard to always check for antifreeze in a car like this because you got that deep neck, but appears to be sufficiently green. Smells good. A little better view at that MSD distributor. Triangle billet air cleaner. Okay. Thanks. We'll head around one side and then the other. We got a small chip right there. Outside it looks really nice. It's really kind of hard to pick this paint apart. The car sits low and doing some miles. It's just got some small general expected wear, but really the execution of it was wonderful. Very nice. I got to clamp that hood back down. No real major, what is that? A little bit of wax and a little tiny scratch. power sunroof was adopted out of a Dodge Caravan, and it seems to motor back and forth nicely. It hides into the body as well as popping up, kind of like it would be designed in a car. I think that's some leftover wax right there. A little easier to see it out here in the light. Jason Phillips from Auto Appraise getting ready to test drive this 1933 Buick for a potential client. We're looking it over real closely because he's out of state and didn't want to fly up here, and checking it out. If you need service like that, you can call us. About 300 inspectors across the nation. They don't all do videos. Mostly I do these. But we do photos and reports in a lot of areas. 800-301-3886. Quick way I work in my commercials. That looks mostly like dust that is cleaning off. So with some expected hairline scratches here and there at the entry point, a few little heel scuffs down here on this running board as well, a couple little entry nicks on that door. I like the way these door handles, they operate. They're kind of like a ball joint almost. But now we get to step back from the car and really take a good look at the lines. And again, they are very presentable. A couple little contact edge nicks right there on the leading edge of the hood. VIN plate mounted for the body. That steering knuckle assembly I was talking about from under the car, easier to see here, done really nicely. Engine starts up cold, no obvious smoking. A little bit of that GM wrist pin noise that is often heard on GM engines. Operable hood louvers, those are pretty sweet. Just been around the vehicle again, just trying again to find any small issues or flaws. A little scratch has been touched up right there. But as a driver quality vehicle, I would say the paint has been really, really well preserved. Those running boards stop a lot of stone splash, and the inset of the tires kind of keep the chips down to a minimum here on these Michigan roads. So nothing too uncommon, too abnormal. I'm dying to get it on the road because it looks like it's going to be a fun car to drive. I went over all the chrome on the car, and it's hard to find any flaws. Everything was either replated or replaced. Fits together nicely, polished nicely, and really, just really nothing to complain about. I would give it all a B+ or better. Window channels were nicely installed. Doors aren't all chipped up. Sometimes you see chip action where they change the window channels, and these look really nice. Antique face, classic instrument gauges. Car showing 0134114, 13,000 miles driven. So obviously someone's had some fun on the road. Vintage air controls. Billet banjo steering wheel with a leather grip that looks real nice. Tilt cruise setup. Power windows are set up down there and an extension on the floor, leathered up nicely. Push-in style fuse harness, billet pedals. Kick panels are real nice. The leather smells really clean and doesn't smell like this was a smoker's car. He might have to be fired up for that to operate. Don't know what these seats are out of. But really nothing to complain about inside the vehicle. It is equipped with seat belts, shoulder harnesses up the B-pillar. I know that that's not lighting up very well, but going through the interior, it's hard to really find any general wear or flaws. I doubt there's been anybody in this back seat. Looks pretty good. Shoulder harnesses back there as well, set up for four passenger. A few entry chips, as you would imagine, have been touched up along the door openings from heels and such passing over the paint. I'm gonna have Louie assist. I'm 6 feet tall. Pull that back a little bit, Louie. Yep. and I'm sitting in the seat right now with no adjustment. I've got about three fingers?
Roughly, yeah, three fingers.
So I got good clearance. I imagine if you were probably 6'3", you would be comfortable in this car. 6'4", you might be dusting the headliner. Electric fuel pump. Tach's working, the stereo face just flipped open. Temperature's down on the bottom. Volts were charging. Oil pressure, we're at about 60-ish or better. Oops, that's a little bit dark for the onlooker to see, but looks like it's about maybe 60, 65 pounds. Vacuum controlled gear shift, that's kind of cool. Low car style shifter. Hey, that is cool. I like that. Louie, roll that window down for me, will you? Hit mine too, please. Windows seem to operate smoothly. Turn signals, check. Oh, horn check. All right, let's take off. Third. Caught the light. Alright, here we go. I'm gonna take my hands off the wheel here once we get up to speed, get through the gears. The steering feels really nice and stable. Hey Louie, would you roll those windows up for me? It'd be a little easier to hear me screaming over the wind. About 50 mile an hour. We're in a 35. I gotta watch it here. I don't want to end up with a ticket on a Friday afternoon. But hand off the wheel. Other one's on the camera. Steering feels nice. I don't feel any unusual wheel hop, and there are some bumps we're traveling across. Feels nice. Pedal goes down. Let's see if you can see that. About halfway through the travel. And back up here, and I'll give them a quick stab with my hands off the wheel. And the car stops nice and straight. And play with the stereo and see if that works. I have no idea how it works, but maybe we'll figure it out. There we go. Stereo works. Can you flip that glove box open for me too?
Oh, you know what? We need the key to do that.
Oh, okay. Never mind then. Shift kit, nothing abnormal, just kind of a regular standard build, nice cruiser. I like driving down this road because it's full of patches and Michigan holes, and you can really get a sense of how the car actually steers and handles and brakes as opposed to going 80 miles an hour. Not real clunky or anything abnormal. Actually, it's pretty quiet inside. Power sunroof works in both directions. It's starting to come up temperature a little bit. I'm going to shut this off and drive a couple more miles so we can just build some temperature. These little entry lights seem to work. Headlights, thank you. Turns. Yep. Like that. Rattles coming right there from that fender. Might need a bolt secured on it. License plate light. Check. Turns, brakes. Yep. Yep. Brakes. Off. Brakes. Off. Brake lights again. Third brake light. Now that we're running, let's check that power seat again. There we go. There we go. All right. Wipers. Let me check the wipers. Yep, there we go. Wipers. AC's on and I'm blowing nice and cold. I don't have my digital temp meter with me, but I can tell that that is much colder than the outdoors. I don't think we're going to be able to build up enough speed to check the cruise. Engine's warming up sufficiently now. And I'm running pretty cool. Holding 50 pounds of oil pressure still. Sounds like we have a country fan. Speakers up in the front kick panel, and I hear music coming out of the back. I didn't notice where those speakers were. All right, let's get out of here. All right. Car's been so far running for 14, almost 15 minutes. We're catching a train up there, so we're gonna sit here and idle again. I'm gonna shut the camera off. Okay, we're moving. The mirrors are set up nice, kind of a nice, that one's not. Pull that in, will you, Louie? But they're at a good level to be able to see from behind. There we go, thanks. And my clearance, my vision path at 6 feet tall, I'm definitely seeing good. I could be a little taller and not be cutting myself off. Just a few other points of interest on a modified car like this. The power seat does have the ability to go down. I think I'm gonna hit pause and drop it down a little further. There we go, now I'm down sufficiently further. Now I'm kinda looking up. The car doesn't seem to have any flat spots and acceleration. Hard to tell if the car's drawn one way or the other with these roads and the condition they're in, but do hands off the wheel one more time. Well, that one is a draw to the right. Set up pretty good. Plenty of room for adjustment if needed. Odometer's turning, speedometer's turning. Car feels good. We're going to shut up and do a wrap up. All right, we're back. I didn't point out that the door locks also work on the car. Car sounds pretty good. Temperature runs at about 141. This little rattle here, I think that could be tended to. You can hear that a little bit. A little bit of an annoyance that could be addressed. Let me hear that engine again. And it seems that the noise that we heard on the cold start, that wristband noise, seems to have subsided. Jason Phillips from Auto Appraise. I'm wrapping up a test drive. First run at 1933 Buick. It's a really nice driving car. It'd be hard to find a whole lot to fault on the car. It's a good solid number two, maybe even two plus car, in my opinion. A little bit of cleanup work. Okay, thanks for watching.